Short beaten nails transformation with hard gel in this video coming up. Hello, I'm Anastasia and today I have a client with short beaten nails and on top of that the cuticle is glued to the nail plate and you can see hangnails and the redness around the nails. So this one is gonna be tough but I think we can do it. Hard gel is also not the easiest product to work on this kind of nails, so I decided to try one thing that I think is gonna work. So it was impossible to push back the cuticle, that's why I did it with electric nail file. First I used green ceramic bead and pushed it back, and now with the softer pink ceramic bead I'm pushing it back even more. I wanted to do the whole cuticle care with electric nail file, but unfortunately I couldn't because the skin of this client is super sensitive and it hurts all the time, so I ended up trimming the cuticle with the scissors. After that, I filed off the surface shine, applied dehydrator and primer, and next step is applying base coat. This is Sock Off Base Coat by Cupa, but I apply it only on the free edge, not on the whole nail, and in a moment you will see why. I decided to try using fiberglass here, because with hard gel we cannot really sculpt it on the skin, it's gonna burn like hell in the lamp, and we could fit the form, absolutely, there are some techniques to that, but I was looking for an easier solution and something tell me that this one might be it. So I apply the fiberglass, we need to make sure that it is fully saturated with the base coat so it will stay there, and I'm working on a pinky now and oh my god, it is so tiny. As you can see, I definitely took more fiberglass than I should, so I will be getting rid of those that we do not need. So normally when you work with fiberglass strands, you simply apply them on the nail and create some kind of like a tip, like the free edge, and then we're going to sculpt the rest. So here the nail is too deep into the nail grooves, so we should be careful by applying that, and we need to make sure we are not touching the skin. So that's why I'm adding this base coat more and more to the sides, because we need to cover the entire surface. Then cure for 30 seconds in LED, and then my favorite moment. We cut the length with nippers. I have a long nippers. Normally they are for manicure, but I use them for these reasons. I also cut the corners because I think oval shape will be a better solution here. And now I'm simply applying the gel on the top. As you can see, there are some strands that were not glued to the nail. We also need to get rid of them. So first layer, I basically glue this fiberglass together. And actually at this point, it already kind of looks like a natural nail. Cure in LED for 30 seconds. And then I'm going to apply the next layer and it is time to build a sculpture. The nail is almost the size of my brush, as you can see, so I have to be super careful here to not touch the surface. And actually, at this point, I realized the mistake that I did. So you see the place where I glued the strands? I definitely did it too high. Normally, when you work with the nails, you apply them only on the free edge, kind of like you would with a regular tip. I don't have a good explanation why I placed them this way, maybe because the nail seemed so short, you know, it kind of felt insecure. I applied the hard gel again, freeze cured for 15 seconds, pinched, and then cured for the remaining 1 minute. Now we need to apply the gel underneath to make sure that all these strands will glue together and stay together, and cure for 30 seconds again. This time you need to cure with the palm up. Next nail, and I'm going to fix my mistake this time. I apply dehydrator and non-acid primer on the entire nail. Then I apply the base coat only on the free edge, exactly on the place where we're going to apply the strands. Now, the mistake was I placed them too high, really close to the cuticle, and near the cuticle, the product should be thin. So I'm afraid we might end up with the strands singing through the product. So we do not want that. So on this nail, I'm going to fix it and once again apply it only on the free edge. I'm afraid that this is the lowest point where I can apply them because as you can see, the corners of this nail plate, they are a little higher than the middle part of the nail bed. And also this nail is rather wide and we have to cover all the width of the nail. So I think this one's gonna work. Anyways, now this fiberglass is in the middle of the nail, exactly where we're going to start building the apex. So I think it should be better. This method will work only if you have a client with the flat nails. Sometimes short beaten nails are also ski jump. So if they are extremely ski jump, this is not gonna work. You will have to use regular forms. So now we cure it for 30 seconds. And once again, my favorite part, cutting the length, yay, and cutting the corners so we'll have less filing. And first I apply hard gel only on the free edge. By the way, I forgot to share, this one is one of my favorite gels. This is NSI Bodybuilder Cover Pink Warm. This is a nice nude color. It is a bit transparent, but I think it's still fine because it makes nails look so natural. Now, when you apply hard gel on top of the fiberglass, make sure it covers the entire surface, cure for 30 seconds, and now I'm going to start building the structure. These nails are so short, so we could do all this within just one step, but I decided to split it into two so I can pinch them because I really want to make them more narrow. So now I freeze cure for 15 seconds and pinch the nail and cure for the remaining 1 minute. Now I'm going to apply more product on the top. For me, the easiest way to do this is first to apply a thin coat of the hard gel you're about to work with, and then take more, place it near the cuticle, press a little bit once it takes the shape of the cuticle and the sidewalls. You just, with a very light stroke, stretch it down. So it's really not hard. If you notice that you're working for too long, you can turn the client's finger around and make sure that the apex is on point. Cure, and after curing, I noticed that still we probably should add a little bit more on the apex area. So I do it all over again. I apply a thin coat on the entire surface, and this time I will be adding only in the center. Because I have enough already near the cuticle along the sidewalls, so why add more product there? Always add it only where you need it. After that, I will cure it again, and we also need to apply the product underneath. Do not forget that whenever you're working with fiberglass. And it's kind of hard actually to do this because of the sidewalls. Then cure with the palm up, as we want this product to be cured everywhere. And then clean the sticky layer, and we need to shape the nails. The surface is pretty good already, so mostly we need to do the shaping itself. Usually the gel files really easy, and especially this one NSI, so I can simply file it only with 180 file. So I carefully file the sidewalls as well as the shape. When doing oval shape, make sure it's symmetrical and always look not only on one nail but on the entire hand. On short beaten nails, I think for short length, this oval shape might be one of the best solutions. If you make them longer, you have more options. You can also do square, you can do almond. But for super short, I think for this particular client, this is one of the best choices, as short square nails might make them look wider than they actually are. With clients who have sensitive skin like this one, sometimes you might want to switch to electric nail file for filing near the cuticle. I did not do it this time because I mostly used the buffer to file the surface and I only used 180 file to shape the nails. When we're done, we need to clean the dust, and as we're using new gel, we can cover it with a top coat. But like I said, I made a mistake on pinky, so maybe the camera doesn't really show it, but there's the line of the fiberglass that it is see-through. That's why I decided to apply the new gel polish on top to cover that. So I'm applying it right now, and obviously we had to do this on all 10 nails. Cure and then seal it with the top coat. Like I said, hard gel on short beaten nails is definitely not the easiest technique, but if you work only with hard gel, I think fiberglass might be a great solution. Like I said, if the nails are growing downwards or if they are ski jump growing upwards, this method will not work, but for normal and flat nails, it will be just perfect. By the way, most short beaten nails are flat, so I think this is one of the best solutions for them. And this is it, this is the beautiful result. I love doing this kind of transformations, and this client, she was so happy when she saw how her nails look like, that they can be feminine, beautiful, and elegant. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. If you're first time here on my channel, consider subscribing as I post nail art tutorials and transformation videos just like this one every week. And I will see you in my next one. Goodbye!